Oh, sorry, didn't see you there. I just got back from the vet. I took Boban grooming today. Since the sun seems to be shining really well, I thought I would vlog a little bit today. If you watched my last video, thank you so much. It somehow became my most watched video ever. And it was like a 10-minute sit-down thing. So I thought I would do something low effort today to kind of recreate the magic of that, although in a very different format. I've been seeing this kind of video floating around YouTube for a while, and I thought I would give it my version, like my twist on it. I don't really have any aim for what today is gonna be like or what this vlog is gonna be like, but I guess like I want to fill up my sketchbook as much as I can and maybe have Halloween as the theme and then chat with you guys as I go along with that. We shall see. I have a lot of things that I think I can talk about with this theme. I really love Halloween, and I think I want to like mix it up with using different materials than usual, and kind of explore as much as I can in terms of styles, in terms of objects that I can draw, composition and all that stuff. I don't know, I've never done this before. I don't really have any idea of how it's going to turn out, but I'm very excited, so come along with me. Let's get started. So let me set the timer for 1 hour and then wait. Okay, before I start, I thought I would give you guys a look at some of the spreads I made lately. I mean, if you follow me on Instagram, you might have seen it. This is the first spread that I did for the sketchbook that is completely filled out. There's no theme to this one, just whatever I felt like drawing. And this one is more to the theme that we're trying to do today. It's not as filled out now that I see it compared to the previous one. But yeah, it was fun to kind of experiment with that. Today I also brought some color pencils, so we can probably do a lot, like explore a lot more on that front. So let's get started. Let's start with something simple. Halloween is the time for pumpkins. So I think I'm just gonna draw a pumpkin. We don't really celebrate Halloween much in Indonesia, at least not while I was growing up. I feel like it's a lot more normal or normalized now to celebrate Halloween. Like a lot of places are doing more Halloween-y activities, but I still feel like I'm missing out on the whole trick-or-treating thing. I don't know if kids today still do trick-or-treating. It feels like it was a safer time when I was growing up to go trick-or-treating, but now I'm not sure. So if you're a parent or you have nieces or nephews who do trick-or-treat, please let me know. I'm really curious and kind of dying to know, really, because, you know, I've never had that experience, so it'll be fun to know if anyone else has that, you know. I really hope this is kind of interesting for anyone to see, because I personally don't know what I'm doing here. I'm sorry, should have planned it out a lot more, but what the hell, I'm always a kind of winged kind of person anyway. And I think October is like the perfect time to do a lot of illustration prompts. I think there's a lot more now than like 5 years ago or something. I used to do a lot of Inktober's, but I realized that's kind of problematic now. I'm not gonna go into it,
but we'll leave some links down below, some like resource links down below if you want to find out what that's all about. But I'm not doing that anymore because of the problem that's associated with Inktober. But I used to do a lot of that in like 2016, I think, 2015, something like that. And I actually did an Inktober on ghosts and monsters and like some really, it was like my proudest moment because I got to figure out a lot of creatures and mythical creatures and spooky beings from around the world. And I find that really, really fun to do, even though obviously I'm not like one of the best at it. I don't know, there's like my imposter syndrome talking. I feel like a lot of people will scold me for saying this, but that's how I felt and how I still feel today. I will try to find the pieces. I think I still have them with me. If I do, I will insert a clip or a photo here. Maybe let's do a little thing with pens now. I don't know. I already did a witch. I think I'll do a fairy now. I'm always fascinated by fairies, and as I understand it, a lot of the mythic creatures that make it to the like modern, I don't know, pop culture, I guess, originate from Ireland. I mean, even like Halloween is an Irish, of Irish origin, as far as I know. I found like a Instagram reel somewhere that shows the celebration of the origin of Halloween, and I thought, and it was in Ireland, and I thought it was really, really interesting. It's like, it almost felt like watching a Ogogo here. I mean, in Bali before Nyepi. If you don't know what that is, I will just leave a link down below for your resources, but I'm not going to talk about it because I really understand it either. It's like I would say the wrong thing if I decide to talk about it. I don't know. What is your like favorite spooky creature, and what do you actually want to dress for Halloween this year? If you follow my blog, which obviously is always linked down below, you may know that I have done a lot of Halloween costumes, and you know, I'm always looking for new costumes to do every year. It's kind of a tradition for myself. Maybe no one cares, or maybe some people look forward to that for me as well. I don't know. All I know is that this is something that I'm doing just for me. And last year, I don't know how it took me so long, like 11 years after I started writing my blog, I finally became a witch, which is very classic Halloween, but for some reason I just never had like the guts, or I don't know why, I never dressed up as a witch before. So that was exciting. But I have this principle of not buying anything new for a costume as much as I can. That's not always true. I don't always stick to that, but when I do, it does make me feel good about myself, you know. And it just so happens that a lot of my clothes are costume-like anyway, so I don't want to really waste that. So if you feel like you don't have anything to wear for Halloween, please look at your closet once again, kind of really examine your clothes. You might have more than you think, you know, because we overlook our clothes a lot, we overlook our belongings a lot, when in fact we have more than we need. Well, I hope that has been in focus this whole time, but if it's not, I'm so sorry. I'm very disappointed in this pen. I bought it a long time ago, have never used it, or I don't use it often anyway. And now its nibs got all dull on me. You have no right to go all dull on me, okay? I haven't used you in ever. So what's the point? You know, I wish this was a live stream situation so I can actually know what you guys think. But technicality wise, I don't know how to figure it out, so. And I don't think I have enough supplies or manpower to figure out. I don't have like a proper desk setup, you know, because I use a laptop and I always put away my laptop after a day's work. So I don't want Bobon, which is my cat, to, I don't know, like sit on my laptop or wreak havoc upon my belongings when I'm not around, which I do not entirely trust her not to do. But alas, anyway. Maybe I should look for inspiration. Let me see, what do I have here? Wait. Okay. That's nice. Yeah, I don't really know how to do this. Just a bunch of eyes with bottles. So yeah, I kind of want to talk a little bit more about the Inktober that I did a while back, about, I don't remember what I call it, like kind of monsters from around the world or something like that. I did a lot of research on mythical beings and spiritual beings from around the globe, from continents, different continents, even the ones from Africa, which I think you can tell a lot about a culture from the kind of creatures they believe to be a monster, or kind of monsters they create as a mythical folklore thing. Because in Africa, I find a lot of mythical and spooky creatures to be men, and they tend to wreak havoc through violence and also SA, basically, and kind of shows the kind of dynamic they have as a community and as a culture. Whereas in Indonesia, for instance, a lot of the creatures tend to be women, and they tend to have a lot to do with religion, which really says a lot about this country to gauge. So yeah. Whereas in the US, I think it has a lot to do with like the natives and nature, like the forest. Maybe that has something to do with how guilty they feel about eradicating. I'm gonna analyze this. So let's not even try. Oh my god, I can't believe I'm already stuck. And page one. Okay, maybe I wanna find Japanese creatures. Yeah, a couple would be nice. Do I have some greens? So, what is Halloween like where you live? As I've mentioned, like in Indonesia, it didn't used to be celebrated a lot, and even today, it's frowned upon in different certain communities. But I think most of us are really having fun with it. It's for us, it's more the trend and the FOMO aspect, I suppose, than the cultural or historical aspect of it. And I think that's what makes it very interesting. Because Halloween, as I read when I was little, stems from like two different cultural practices, as far as I know. It's a thank you for the harvest that, like, the crops that have been harvested, but also the to ward off the evil spirits and all. Both of which makes a lot of sense, and I think especially like in Ireland, where I feel like the creatures are very close to nature, it makes so much sense to thank the good spirits, so to speak, while also warding off the evil ones. Oh my god, this papa is very rock and roll somehow. I don't know what I'm doing. Okay, let's talk a little bit less about Halloween for a second, and I want to talk to you about my previous vlog. I think the biggest surprise of my previous vlog is how my friends decided to watch my vlog together. And they think I am really confident in front of a camera, like this, like I'm talking to a camera, I'm really confident. But that's only because there's no one behind the camera. If you can see the setup right now, it's literally just me being cornered by cameras on all sides. And, you know, there's no one else in the room, which is key to me being able to speak so candidly to you guys, you know. But I don't know if I can do that. Like, I can do the same thing in a more studio setting. They feel like I can be a great MC, and I'm like, I am not a great MC. I would, like, this video will prove that I am actually not very good at talking, because the last video was obviously scripted. This video, not so much. I have nothing prepared in terms of what to say and like key talking points, and where I should just shut up, don't talk, which is why you fight me. Changing the subject midway through. Not very good at this. But I do love talking randomly. I feel like I have a lot to say a lot of the time. And sometimes you just don't have anyone to share that with. I mean, I have my boyfriend who always listens to what I have to say, which is so saintly of him, because I do have too much to say. I don't make a long story short. I make a longer story long. TLDR just doesn't apply to my life. Like, I'm always TL, you know? But sometimes I just want to talk. And it's okay if you're not really listening. It's okay if you have nothing to add. Just let me vent and say stuff. Ah, this cupboard's turning out to be so detailed. I really like using color pencils these days. I feel like through this vlog, I have a newfound appreciation for color pencils. I used to think, oh, crayons are the best, but then I tried crayons, as you know, in my one art a day vlog, and it was hard. Wasn't my thing at all. I feel like colored pencils, or at least in particular the one I'm using right now, which is a Derwent colored pencils, which is Derwent colored pencils, are actually the best. It's a middle ground between a soft pastel, which I enjoy using. I love the effect of soft pastel, and I think it's much easier to use. But the color doesn't really pop out as much as I'd like for it to be. And that's when color pencils come in. I love actually mixing soft pastels with colored pencils. It pops the color nicely, but also still keeps that soft touch very well. Whereas crayon, I think, is very cross, very harsh. So yeah, there's that. I don't know. Sorry guys, having a Halloween party this year, like at your office or at home with friends, I don't know, like a whole event somewhere. My sister and I went to a Halloween event in 2014, I think. It was literally the only Halloween event we've ever attended. And other than that, I've only ever been like to Halloween party at the office or like at a nearby bar when I was living in Germany. That was really a lot of fun. And yeah. But I always dress up for Halloween, even if there's nothing going on. Actually, usually a lot of my Halloween posts were taken before Halloween, obviously. So they can be posted on Halloween, and they tend to just be like a random, well, not random, but like an ordinary day going to the mall or something. And my boyfriend Agung tends to be pretty embarrassed after the photo shoot. He'd be like, please put something else on, or like remove the makeup or remove the accessory that makes it very costumey, because people will stare, and they usually do. But you know, I said, whatever. Yeah, sure, why not? Ooh, let's talk a bit more about reading. Reading is my passion. I'm an avid reader. I have like yearly reading goals. And this year's goal is actually pretty simple. And a lot of that goal is to read. Well, this year my goal is 30 books. For a while it was 50 books, but I haven't read 50 books in, I guess, 6 years. And that's because I have been opting more towards quality than quantity. When I had like 50 books a year kind of a goal, I tend to be very compromise on the kind of things that I read, which is not really good, because the whole point of reading more is to read things that you care about, to learn about things that you care about. And if your attitude towards that is like, read whatever, I think it's not very healthy. I mean, maybe for a while my goal was to have quantity over quality, but I think we're past that by now, because I'm really good at keeping up with reading. So I wouldn't say I'm behind on my reading right now, but when I'm not ahead, I feel like I'm behind. So that's where I'm at right now. I'm at 22 books right now. My goal is 30. I've been reading all kinds of books lately. I've been loving Zadie Smith for years. I wanted to read her works, but for some reason I've never found her books available to me in a way that I like, which is used. But somehow this year I stumbled upon 3 Zadie Smith books, and I am currently at my 3rd Zadie Smith book. I'm really, really super excited to continue reading it, because I've been like putting it off since it's really huge physically. But yeah, so that's kind of my obsession right now is Zadie Smith. And I guess like Sally Rooney also has like a book out this year. And I think a lot of people at my work is into Sally Rooney, so been into that too. And of course, my forever love is Jhumpa Lahiri, and I'm currently reading one of her earlier works, and I'm very excited. It really shows what she was like at first, what her writing style was like at first, and how I guess maybe it'll later on develop into what I have discovered previously. But she always kind of sticks with the same theme, which I think is like her niche, I guess. But it stems from her real experiences, so that's Always so interesting. What do people do usually when they sketch like this, like in a video like this? I'm not gonna lie, I haven't really watched a lot of it. Maybe I should have done my research. I only watched Sean's one. I will link it down below, but I'm sure you already know who Sean Dantes is. And her sketchbook video was more about her Beachtober preparation, which, okay, I really want to join Beachtober and a lot of the October illustration prompts, but I just don't have the time right now. I have, again, I mean, obviously, you know, if you watch my previous video, I have my full-time job, which really takes up a lot of my time. Other than that, I also have my side jobs, which takes up the rest of my time. I mean, I'm already like behind on my Patreon rewards, which is not funny. It's just super bad of me. I'm so sorry to my patrons. This video is part of that, I guess. So I really just don't have more space on my plate right now. I don't know how everyone else does it. Maybe because they don't. Maybe art is not like a side job or side thing for them. Okay, back to the Halloween theme. Which horror movie have you been binging lately? I haven't really done any horror movie binging. I've been trying so hard to watch Smile. The first one, because I don't think the second one is out yet. But yeah, the first one. And it is literally my nightmare. I'm a simple woman. Okay? Just some random person smiling in that creepy way is enough to scare the bejesus out of me. So, thanks to whoever made that movie. If I ever finish it, I probably won't be able to sleep. Especially if Bobon decides not to come home because of some guy. It's kind of been happening with her. I said I was going to experiment with composition. I don't think I'm doing that. I think I'm just drawing willy-nilly. I don't think there's much science or reasoning to what I'm doing here. Let's just draw a random flower for a second. What's your favorite flower? Every drawing is a question in this sketchbook. My favorite flower, to be perfectly honest, is a hydrangea. And I kind of want to go to Japan during hydrangea season, because I've been seeing it on like in manga and anime. It just looks so, it has like a particular, I find it has a particular vibe, so I'm gonna be a part of that. Okay, I think it's going to be Asar soon, which is the call to prayer will probably sound anytime soon. So I might have to stop talking. So I'm just gonna draw without saying anything significant. I don't know if you can hear it already because it's kind of starting right now.
Okay, so this is what we've done in the past hour. Not a lot, like not much. Not as much as I thought it was gonna be. For some reason in my mind, like 1 hour will give me like several spreads. Obviously I'm delusional, especially since I'm doing this aimlessly. but my other camera's battery just died and it's getting really dark. So I think I'm gonna call this a day. I think this is where I'm gonna end this. Thank you so much for following along. If you're also sketching with me, please tag me on your social media if you're gonna post your sketch, or just, I don't know, send it to me here maybe, or on my Patreon, wherever, like DM on Instagram is fine too. I'd love to see what you made. And also I hope, at least if it's not like visually interesting what I have shown you here, at least I hope it was fun for you to follow along. And yeah, I really, really, really love Halloween. I think there's like a lot of things we can explore visually in terms for Halloween. So this has been really fun for me. If you haven't joined my Patreon, I will leave a link down below so you can check out my Patreon and see what it's all about. You don't have to be a paid member to join. I'm thinking about making something for the free members as well sometime soon-ish. So stay tuned. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!